Every industrial automation designer must know how to select the right enclosure for a control cabinet. When designing automation systems, I recommend you to use modern web tools that will speed up your work and allow you to earn more money in the future. Take a look in the front of you. There is a 3D model of a control cabinet for industrial machine, a pallet wrapper in this case. In our company, we generated this model based on electrical schematic. Now, your task is to select an enclosure for your control cabinet in which you will mount such devices like PLCs, inverters, or electrical protections. Also, lamps, ventilators, and heaters. Hit the like button down below the video, subscribe the channel, and let's get started with this video.
Besides choosing automation devices, it is equally important to select the enclosure for your control cabinet. Now it's time to choose the enclosure where you will place mounting rails and then install the components. I am on the page of a sample enclosure. The enclosure has two plain dolls and a mounting plate to which you can attach the mounting rails. You can choose such an enclosure yourself based on the catalog. However, I would like to show you today a modern approach to selecting components for industrial automation projects. If you want to work in Industry 4.0, it is worth using tools provided by automation manufacturers, especially free web configurators. In this video, you will learn how to choose an enclosure using the retail company's web configurator. Below this video, I left you a link to cabinet configurator and we'll choose an option to start configuration. Here you can choose several options: large industrial enclosures, low voltage switch gears, and we'll use small and compact enclosures. Click on Configure now. On the left side, we select the most important parameters for our control cabinet. Here we have type of enclosure and we will check AX option. These are series enclosures perfectly suited to our application. Next, we select material. We'll use sheet steel. You can also use plastic enclosure if you want to, but we'll use sheet steel. Next, we have the dimensions. Let's go to width, 1000 millimeters. Look at that all dimensions are provided in millimeters here. Let's go to height. It will be 1200 millimeters and depth 300 millimeters. Let's go to doors. We'll add two doors and IP protection class. Let's assume that your control cabinet will be located indoors. So IP55 protection class will be more than sufficient. The configurator displays the parameters you selected. On the right side, you'll find a 3D view of your enclosure. You can go here and click on large view. Here you can check how the control cabinet looks in 3D. You can change the view and check if it meets your requirements. Okay, let's close the preview. And let's move on. Click Next to proceed. In the next step in the design process, we will choose accessories for our control cabinet. At the top, you select the handle for this control cabinet with the insert. You can choose the shape of this insert. I choose double bit 3mm insert. You can buy such a key in any electrical store. It looks like this. So it simply has two blades with which you can insert the key into the lock and open the cabinet. Okay, now you know what a double bit looks like. You can now click on add option. Here I have a message that the insert has been added and also it is indicated here on our preview. Next, we insert the plinth system. By default, we insert the AX plinth system and it is sheet steel. You can also adjust here plinth height and click on add. Let's look on the larger view. Thanks to the plinths, the cabinet will stand on an elevation. Thanks to this, we can safely place the cabinet anywhere on our site. Okay, let's close the view and let's move on. As an option, we can add 180 degrees hinge to expand the opening angle on the door for added convenience when working. Thanks to this, the operator can work more comfortably. Let's add it. And on the view, you see that we have been added hinges. I hope that you already have knowledge about the protective circuit construction. If not, just join our industrial automation basic course down below the video. So we'll add airfin straps for establishing a secure airfin connection with optimum contact. This will make my work easier, and the airfin straps will come with the enclosure to my automation workshop. The question is whether I need a protective roof for my control cabinet. My control cabinet will be located indoors, that's why I don't need protective roof, so I will not add this option to my configuration. And here we have LED system light. In my opinion, LED lights are essential in control cabinets for clear visibility, making maintenance and inspection easier. They ensure quick and efficient work in any lighting conditions. So we'll add it to our project. According to our experience, every control cabinet should be equipped with an electrical schematic, which is why it's worth adding a wiring plan packet. It ensures quick access to documentation during maintenance. Without documentation, after some time, the control cabinet will look like this, and that's probably something we don't want. It will be very useful in our project, so add it here. Times are changing, and now we have a revolution. You can store schematics in the cloud and access them using QR code with Retail ePacket tool. You can add here your electrical schematic created in ePlan and add it to that tool. I will briefly return to the 3D model of my control cabinet. For example, here I have terminal blocks with power circuits for motors. Here, wires are routed directly from the contactors. Here we have output circuits where we connect the wires that lead directly to the motor power supply. These wires must be routed through the enclosure, and for this purpose, cable glands are installed. In our project, we'll use plastic gland plate with metric knockouts. Thanks to that, we can break through the plastic on the knockouts for cable glands. Thanks to that, we will route wires to the motor through the enclosure. I think this solution is very convenient, especially since after the configuration is finished, the cabinet that arrives at your automation workshop will be equipped with such a gland. Here we have an example of such a cable entry, and your enclosure from the configurator will have the option to break out these knockouts and route the cables to the motor. Now you know how to use plastic gland plates, that's why I will add it to my project view. Let's see that in the larger view. Here we have plastic glands. Now you can break out specific sections and pass the motor cables. Okay, it is the last option, plastic gland plates. And we can go to accessories. And here we can adjust our configuration. We have more accessories, like we can customize base, door and locks. Like we can add window for our door. Here we have interior installation. We can configure system lights, airfin, cable management. Look at that picture. We can route cables through cable gland. And also we have climate control devices like ventilators, heaters, and cooling units. In some applications, you need to add climate control devices. Okay, let's go to Modification tab, and here you can modify each area, like top area, left front door, right front door, mounting plate, and much more. Let's go to your configuration. This is summary of your configuration, and here you have the type of your enclosure. In the preview, you can see each part of your configuration. It is highlighted in green, like here you have mounting for LED lights, wiring plant package, and plastic glands. Okay, that's all. You can finish your configuration. You can get technical data, or you can directly request an offer from that system.
Thanks for watching. We hope you found this video helpful, and right now you know how to select the right enclosure for your control cabinet using modern web tools. Stay tuned for upcoming videos with more tools and tips in industrial automation. Let's keep learning together.